I'm Matthew Gentry. I'm a professor in the College of Medicine at University of Kentucky, and my research focuses on both epilepsy and biofuels, which are two things you would think are not very closely related. The reason we study both is because we're interested in proteins, and proteins are the workers inside of a cell. They're the machines that make things happen. Our really groundbreaking discovery came when we found that this plant protein does a specific process. Both plants, as well as algae, and humans have to store sugars. They use the same proteins to do that. And in plants, if you can harness those proteins that are storing the sugars, then you can control biofuels. And in humans, if you have mutations in those proteins, then you get this fatal epilepsy disease called LaFora's disease. It's an ultra rare disease, so only say 1 out of 1.5 to 2 million people suffer from it. So you might ask, why should the NIH, the National Institutes of Health, fund a disease like that? And the answer is that, it gives us insights into how the body works that we wouldn't otherwise understand. And so this particular disease, the kids develop normally until around age 12 to 15. They have an epileptic episode, and then those episodes increase in both severity and number over the next decade. And then by age 25 to 30, 100% of the patients die. And so it's an incredibly devastating disease because the parents lose a child, but the diagnosis typically doesn't happen until around age 18. So by then they probably have more kids. And there's a 25% chance that each of their kids could have the disease. We put together about a year and a half ago a collaborative team with myself here at UK, a group at Indiana University, a group at UT Southwestern, a group in Barcelona, and one in Madrid, focused on pooling our collective knowledge and effort to cure the disease. The discoveries that we made in the plant system were directly applicable to the human system, and that led us down this road now of studying this human disease with the realistic and hopeful possibility of a cure in the next 2 to 5 years. I do quite a bit of science advocacy, and the group that I'm a part of, the American Society for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, we advocate that money shouldn't be set aside for specific diseases, because while you're researching disease X, you can find something that impacts disease Y. And if you set that money aside, then you don't let the best science get done. I mean, I started working on plant proteins, and I'm now working on a human disease. You just have to go where the science takes you and be willing to go on that journey. The most difficult challenge that we face is funding. And so from 1997 to 2007, the US did a doubling of the National Institutes of Health budget. And so about 35 to 40% of all scientific ideas were being funded and turned into fundable projects that people could work on. But then from 2007 until now, we've seen stagnation, and we've lost about 20% of our purchasing power. And that means that only about 12 to 15% of ideas get funded. So scientists now spend really an inordinate amount of time writing grants instead of doing the work. And so that's frustrating to see that happen. So, I and others do a lot in the advocacy space where we contact our congressmen and senators and let them know that this biomedical work, it's important for our nation in terms of budget, in terms of being competitive overseas, and in terms of our healthcare. So the environment here at UK is uniquely strong because of its breadth and depth. We look at the different colleges. We've got the College of Ag, we've got the College of Engineering, we've got the College of Medicine, and then the Arts and Sciences campus. And so to have that breadth of knowledge here is incredibly exciting, especially for my lab, where we are bouncing between agriculture and human disease. And you couple that with the infrastructure that the current leadership has invested in, it's an exciting time to be here. And it's exciting just to be able to focus on science and do science and not have other distractions.